This is my new set of grasshopper escapement pallets for my long case clock. The pallet stems are old minute hands, probably off alarm clocks, and the mounting part in the centre with the grub screw, that was probably a crutch off a striking clock. That's the grasshopper assembly in situ. The whole movement is very strange. There have been pivot holes drilled and then filled in again for no apparent reason. And there are hammer marks on the plates and odd casting flaws here and there. Most interestingly, there have been two different heights for the pallets when this clock was being made. There were two sets of holes for the screws holding the pallet bridge. And obviously two corresponding heights of pivot on the front plate. You might not see them very well in this, but it shows that the original deadbeat escapement had been mounted at the wrong height and had been altered. Now, it was very handy when I was putting the grasshopper escapement in it, because that needs quite a high pallet centre. Also, I've just noticed something else. The main wheel isn't even in straight. Is at a slight angle. The pivot holes have been drilled slightly skew. However, it works perfectly, so I see no need to try and alter it. This is the first grasshopper escapement I've ever known I could do this with. Something else I've added to this clock is bolt and shutter maintaining power. Grasshopper escapements need a constant driving force, and bolt and shutter maintaining power helps to achieve that. I fitted a lever which goes across the movement from one side to the other, and it's pulled down by a lead weight on a cord. The bolt and shutter maintaining power is raised by pulling a cord down. Now, I can't get to it in this position, so I'll raise the lever up by hand, and this will hopefully show you how the ratchet click engages with the wheel of the movement. That ratchet click will push that wheel around and drive the movement while the clock is being wound. I'll try and show you it in operation. It runs approximately 30 seconds. Well, that's it working. And finally, the dial is fitted and the clock is complete.